Well, good evening. The reason I'm talking to you this evening is really all Rob Stevens's fault. Rob's now probably sitting there going, oh, what have I done now? Well, basically, a few months ago, during the early part of the COVID pandemic period, Rob got in touch with me and said, oh, I'm quite fancy doing a paddle of the River Thames in the UK. He'd had a look at the map and worked out that it was only about 90 miles, stopping at a pub or so, he could knock it off in a couple of days. Well, that really then was the kernel of this idea for my presentation, because the River Thames is actually 220 miles long. It starts up in Gloucestershire, it finishes in London. If you work out that in the UK there are something in the order of 50,000 pubs, many of which are along the rivers. You'll find pubs along the rivers, at locks, at bridges, at ferry points. And so it would take more than a couple of days to do the Thames in reality, because part of the written law in the UK is that if a pub's open, you've got to go in. Be rude not to. The idea of my presentation is not to be a TripAdvisor report upon places to paddle and to see, but to give you a taster of parts of the UK where you can paddle, enjoy some of the scenery off the rivers, and basically enjoy England at its best. So sit back, enjoy, and we'll see how we get on. I'm presently just sitting here on my river, which is the Little Ouse. I keep looking upstream because there's an otter or something playing around up there. It's a wonderful spring day. I'm only interrupted periodically by the sound of some fighter jets out of Lake and Heath Base, which are a little bit more active at the moment because of Mr. Putin, but we'll say no more about that. So please enjoy my presentation, and we'll have a question and answer session at the end. With pubs all along the river, it creates a convenient way of starting a group paddle, because you can arrange to meet at the pub, use their car park, and then paddle from the pub. And we may well
finish the paddle at a pub, and on the way stop at a pub. The normal arrangement is to let the landlord know that you're going to turn up, so that he's aware of you can be using his car park, and then afterwards we'll all go in and have a beer and something to eat, which helps him for helping us. The book Pub Paddling, which I've shown you, has a whole selection of pub paddles in the southern part of the UK. You'll struggle to find that book in the States, but the good thing is that it will be in the auction at the end of the assembly. That's on the basis that Colin Whitehead has remembered to bring it. So I would suggest that everybody now look at Colin and see if he's nodding that he's remembered to bring it and give it to Annie. If not, you'll hear the screeching of tyres from the car park as Louise makes tracks for London, Ontario to go and fetch it.
Thank you. I've got an addiction. Showed up last week for an intervention. Took inventory and made a few notes. They said, look around you, son, you got too many boats. I've got too many irons and too many fires, too many projects, I won't deny it. But when it comes down to anything that floats, there's no such thing as too many boats. Driving down the road with a trailer in tow. Cop pulled me over for going too slow. Said you're in a heap of trouble and it's no joke. Look behind you, boy, you got too many boats. I've had too many tickets but not enough quarters. Too many exes, too many lawyers.
The question that's often put to me by Angelica is, how many canoes do you actually need? Well, there is only one stock answer to that, and the answer is one more than I actually have. So remember that next time you're picking up your next canoe. I'm really constrained by space, but through the WCHA connection, I tend now to be the go-to man for adverts and people inquiring about selling or rehoming wooden canoes. I didn't need another canoe, but some friends of mine a few months ago met a couple up on the Norfolk Broads who said, oh, we've got an old canoe that we'd like to rehome because we're both in our 80s. We're retiring and it's really surplus to requirements. My friend said, oh, Nick Dennis will have it. You know, he's the wooden canoe man. I resisted, but resistance with canoes tends to be futile a lot of the time, and eventually I gave in. I got in touch with them. I sent them details of how I thought would be best to sell the canoe or to rehome it, because I didn't need another canoe. They however insisted that I go and see them, so I did. I drove up and met this lovely couple who are boat builders on the Norfolk Broads, specializing in the construction of wooden electric boats to a superb quality. The story behind the canoe that they had is that John, the boat builder, had been asked by a client to find him a canoe. So John put the feelers out and someone got in touch, and they went and met a 95-year-old lady who said, I've got a canoe in my boathouse. They pulled everything out and out came a canoe, an old wooden canoe that she can remember her father buying from new. So effectively it's a one owner canoe. They pulled the boat out, had a good look at it, and the client said, no, don't want that. So they left it. John then got a call from the lady saying, look, you either put the canoe back where it came from or you can have it. So he took it. He fully restored it, and in all honesty is probably over restored it. It is a canoe made by Turks of Kingston upon Thames. So the canoe is 16'8" long. It came with floorboards and a couple of little seat backs that literally just prop like that, and you'd put a cushion against those to sit down. There's a pair of those, they're both original. At the stern is this strange little seat or shelf that fits onto a couple of brackets there. It's just supported. I suspect that's more for putting things on, because trying to sit on that is possible, but you've got to hook your legs over this thwart here. You can see the finish of the canoe and all the detailing. I love these details here, and I also like the decks and the detail at the front here, all of which is original. And there's the Turks build-up plate there. So that is an 1800 Turks canoe from Kingston upon Thames in London.